Hi, this is Anne for Graphic Design How To, and today I'm going to show you how to make a swish or a swoosh and put some cool little effects on it and also attach text to it. So let's get started. I'll use mostly the pencil tool for this. You can also use the brush tool. It's really awesome if you have a Wacom tablet because you can do pressure sensitive stuff and it works really well. But if you don't have a Wacom, you can always use the pencil tool. So let's hit that now. That's the end tool. All right, so first, let's try to mimic this shape. Now this is not gonna be exactly the same as the one below, but we'll try to get it as close as I can. All right, I'm gonna hit E because I can tell that it's not quite following the shape, and I'll click here on the side, and then I'm gonna hold Command, and that way I can drag it up like that. So it's pretty close now. Now I'm gonna use the Smooth tool, and to get to that, I use Shift S, and that'll bring you right here to the Smooth tool. I had to set up my own keyboard shortcut for that. That is under Edit, Keyboard Shortcuts. And then you choose the Smooth tool, and then you click here, and you can hit Shift S, and it will overwrite wherever Shift S was being used before. Hope that's okay with you. If it's not, don't do it. Anyway, let's smooth this out. And to do that, I'm gonna just go over that shape and just keep going over it until it's all smooth. Okay, that is pretty, whoops, I'm gonna undo that. If you ever have the Smooth tool do something you don't like, just feel free to go ahead and undo Command Z. Okay, now let's get the pencil tool because I want it to curl in more, kind of like this one. So that is in. So I'm going to use this to reshape this. And if you start along the same path, it will reshape to wherever you want it to. I might do the same up here just to have a little bit higher. There we go. Okay, so I think our path is ready. I'm going to go ahead and increase this to about 35, the stroke. And then we're going to come down here to Profile and choose this Width Profile one. Okay, and that gets us pretty close. We'll go ahead and say 105, see how close that gets us. That will probably do just fine. Okay, so we can see here it's not quite a circle, so let's go back to the Smooth tool, and we'll just try to smooth that out a little bit so it's not so pointy there. Up here it looks okay. And let's zoom in with the Z tool. Right here. I don't like the way this is looking. So with the A tool, I'm going to click on just that point and then curve that anchor so it's not being so weird. Now Command minus to zoom out. And looks like this is sort of weird here again. I'm just going to smooth that out a little bit. All right, so we're very close now. Yeah, I'm liking that. That is pretty close. All right, so now we should expand this. That's Command E. I mean, that is Object Expand Appearance. I get these two mixed up, so I just hit both of them randomly. But this is my own keyboard shortcut, so I just think you should go to Object Expand Appearance. Okay, and that gives us a whole ton of points, which doesn't really matter. That's fine. Still, this shape here is bothering me a little bit, so I'm going to smooth it out. Smooth, smooth, smooth. Okay, maybe down here too. All right. Well, anyway, it doesn't have to be perfect for now. You will want to make yours perfect, of course. Now, as far as the word is concerned, I'm going to smooth this just to reduce the number of points because I'm going to use this part as my text type path. So Shift S to get to the Smooth tool and just kind of go over that. Okay, we have way less points now, and that's great. Now with my A tool, I am going to draw a square, a rectangle, across these points and grab those holding Shift, grab some of these too. Okay, so now you can see that all of these are white and these up here are black dots. White dots, black dots. The black dots are filled in dots, are actually blue, are the ones we're going to be copying. So I'm going to copy that and then I'm going to deselect all, Shift Command A, and then paste in front. And so now you can see if we move this up here, we only have those points that I highlighted with the A tool. I'm going to move them back down. We'll put them right about there. And I don't really need, I'll put a stroke on. I just hit Shift X to flip between fill and stroke on that. Okay, so now we have our type path. Let's go ahead and grab the type on a path tool. And I'll just click on that line. Ew. I wonder why that was happening. Maybe I can't have a fill here or a stroke. So let's clear that off, take it off here, just drag it to that. Let's see if it'll work now. Okay, so now it works. And let's type fabulous. Okay, super small, obviously. Okay, so the font for this is a Google font and it's called Pacifico Regular. Let's change this to about 75. All right, that's still way too small. Let's go with 100, 250. All right, we're getting there. Okay, so you can see how it will curve along that line. Let's put it 150. Okay, and now we can do Shift Command and Brat and period to make it bigger slowly. Okay. Now I want this to start all the way back here, maybe, so it'll line up a little better with this. And now we'll just take the whole thing with the V tool and line it up manually. Okay, so we're getting really close at this point. Let's change it to pink by using the I tool. And clicking on the pink. Now our text is pink. And at this point, I'm going to take my P tool, my pen, and just draw a little shape up here to kind of complete the attachment. Okay. And now for these little flourishes down here. Aaron Draplin made a video about how to make these, and it was so cool, so I'm going to do it the same way he did. He takes two circles like this, hold Shift so it's an exact circle, and overlap, and hold Option, and then select both, and then click Intersect, and that will give you that little piece of the shape. We'll want to rotate. That's the R tool, and you can hold Shift to get a 45 degree angle. Okay, so I'm going to copy, paste in front, and then hit O to get your reflect tool over here, and hold Option and click, and then it'll bring up this box. You can say vertical, and now you have those shapes. I'm going to move them apart a little bit. Okay, let's pull these over here. And I'll go ahead and Pathfinder unite them. And now we can just Shift, Option, and drag down. And then you can do Command D, 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 D. So each Command D will repeat it. And we only really need about half of those, maybe. Okay. So I'm going to copy this, paste in front. That's Command F. And then rotate, or you can use this E tool, free transform, to just get to that. Hold Shift to make it exactly at the angle, and drag it down. And then we'll put a little dot in the center, like this. We'll align everything, and then resize holding Shift and Option. So now we've got our shape. I'm going to go ahead and group that, Command G, zoom in with the Z tool. And then E for transform, I'm going to just kind of look at it and judge and say, where do I want this? Oh, that looks about right. Okay, so they're pink, it's pink. I'm gonna give this a white fill and a black outline. To do that, all you have to do is hit D. Okay, and then I don't want the black stroke, so I'm gonna hit my question mark. And it's gone. All right. So this is pretty much, might turn it a little bit more. And if you really want to, you can go and to effect and warp, arch it a little bit so that it matches the flow of that. But I think this is good enough for now. There you go. Let me know if you have any questions or comments. If you like this video, please hit the like button. And if you want to see more videos like this, please subscribe. This is Anne for Graphic Design How To. Thanks.